it's kind of like, well, what more do you need? But for you to continue and then think it's going to do something differently, it's not, because it started off on the wrong foot.
Now, Kadar, what do you think it seems like Yahusha Beam treats Jerrica better than Trina? What is your expert opinion on that? I mean, are all of us wrong?
Nah. I definitely see it. And trying to go into the mind of Yahusha Beam, I probably would say it's more of the, like you say, the honeymoon phase. As to, you know, when you know, that beginning stage of being with a woman, you know, you be so into her to where you don't even realize a lot of the things that you're doing. So I kind of think it's that. And I don't know, maybe it can be that he sees, you know, more progression in her or something like that. But at the end of the day, knowing that you a husband of two wives, you have to, you can't allow yourself to be swayed in either direction. You got to stand as a king and treat them both equally. Like you got to, like the scriptures say, the first wife shouldn't miss nothing. So it's like, it seems to me like he's more into the second wife. And he's starting to forget about the first wife. And then at the end of the day, you can't move like that, because then you the one who creating the problem that you might be pushing off on the first wife. So I think that they need to spend more time together collectively, because that's the only way to get the, you know, the jealous feelings and this, that, and the third out. So if they more so be together collectively, then you can observe the behaviors of both of them at the same time, and you can see who's actually the problem and address it.
Exactly.
But you know, in a way, you in a way, and you one place more of the time than the other, of course it's gonna seem like the other one, because she cried for the attention or the time that she missed. So that's just my expert.
Crystal,
opinion.
You got background noise. Mute yourself.
It might be me, because I'm in the
No, that was Crystal. That was Crystal. I saw it as soon as she came on. It's still there, man. Every time she comes on, it's like that.
Yeah, so I would look at it more so as him. That's why I gave him those pointers that time, for them to spend more time collectively, because that's just the best thing to do, because you literally gonna be able to observe them and you'll see who tooting the nose up and who got an attitude with this and that. And that's the only way for them to get along, because that separate thing, to me, the separate households, it makes it easier if things go wrong and all in. And if you got a marriage, a polygamous marriage, we're supposed to be all in building this thing. So right. That's how I look at it, huh?
All right.
Give me a minute. I'm searching. I'm gonna show him how to
do it. All right. You threw him a pass, but I'm gonna have to be Ronnie Lott and interrupt that pass that you're trying to throw him. You dig? I don't. With me, man, to hell with your feelings. I'm gonna just keep it all the way funky, man. See, the first thing you said, yeah, that was a nice pass, but I'm gonna intercept that. So I'm Ronnie Lott. What? So I don't think it's the honeymoon stage. I think it's a little late for that, because I think he's been dealing with Jerrica for over a year. That honeymoon stage is about over. You dig? So my expert opinion, you know what I think it is? Because I pay attention. I watch things. I listen. I think it's because, now, I want you to think back to some of the things that he's been saying openly. I think it's because Jerrica came in. She lost a lot of weight. She's slimmer, and he's more attracted to that now. Now, notice, before you form any kind of opinion, notice he's been recently saying he's been kind of talking down against bigger women now. Well, Remember what he said? I would never go through that again. It was too much hard of a walk. Why? Could it be? Word of Richard Burks. Think about what I'm saying. He said, I would never want to go through that again. So now he's making it seem as though that, you know, pretty much, you know, I can't necessarily say it was a mistake, but you heard his own words the other night. He would never go through that again. It's too hard, right? So Jerrica has lost a lot of weight. And so this is what I believe it is. And now, since Jerrica has lost a lot of weight, he's looking at her, and this is, might be painful, but they need to hear it. He's looking at her as, you know, him being more attracted to her, and which is kind of, you know, in the natural nature of a man, unless he, you know, he like heavier women, but because men are more attracted to women that have curvy bodies when he's in his proper mindset and so on and so forth. But it's just the way that men are. A woman's body is designed a certain way. If she keep her body like the Most High designed it, most men, and the fact is, most men, this is what I can say about men. If one man see a woman attractive, almost every man's going to see that woman attractive. That's a fact. If one woman see a man attractive, I mean, if one man see a woman attractive, almost every man you meet is going to say, yeah, she's attractive. That's a fact. Because men don't see things like women do. It's like, yeah, she's bad, man. She's bad. Well, but you know, so I contend, and this is just my perspective. I'm entitled to that. That is because Jerrica has lost a lot of weight. He see her as more. I mean, come on, man. Let me ask you this, man. How many times do you think the Beam has taken Trina to one of his work sites or to his job sites? You don't think the other woman's gonna feel that that's being favorite? If you got a new sister wife and you've been taking her because you know why? It's like a trophy to him. I know men think, man. I've written books on this stuff. So that's like his trophy that he wants to show off. But now remember what I told you guys, man, about the big woman that lost weight.
Thanks.
That's my opinion, man. Truth hurts, man. But yo, you gotta eat that. That's my perspective. That's my truth of what's going on with that situation. And so, you know, we often forget. See, this is what you can't forget. And I'm not telling him to get on the pity party, right? But you gotta remember, it's Katrina was the one that was there for you, man. Well, all of your children that wasn't even her, man. Get your mind right, kid. I'm gonna have to say that. She's the one that was there supporting you, man. Not Jerrica. She was supporting you and your five children, man. Get your mind right. See, some dudes, man, they start thinking with the wrong mind, man. You dig? You can't forget that, man. You can't forget that. A real man wouldn't forget that. See, this is what I'm going to say to every real man, man. If a woman is there with you when you're down, whenever you get up, if you're a real dude, you're supposed to remember that woman, man. You understand what I'm saying? That's a fact, man. That's a fact. But if you ain't been raised by a man, you don't know how to really be a man. You could try and guess. You could try and pump fake. But a real man wouldn't handle that like that, man. Because that woman was there A1 since day one. You can't forget all of that, man. No real man's not going to forget that, man. But you think Denzel stayed with his woman so long? Because she was there with him in the beginning, man. They was like, yo, well, how come you don't have a more attractive wife? You see, I mean, your mind, a lot of these dudes, man, they don't know how to think. Your mind's not right. You with something, man. If that woman rolled you like that, rolled with you like that from the inception, you got a true rider, man. Ain't nobody supposed to be able to move her, man. But dudes haven't been taught to think like men anymore, man. They pump fake. So that's what it is, man. That's my perspective, man. And you can like that, understand it, believe it or not.